Hey guys, it's Jessica from DeliciousObsessions.com, and it has been a really long time since I've done a grocery haul video. So I thought I would do one today because I did a pretty big shopping trip and I thought I would show you what all I got and tell you a little bit about what I'm going to do with it. So you'll notice tons of veggies. So I really have upped my veggie consumption game. I feel so much better when I'm eating a ton of vegetables. So that is what I'm doing. So this is all from Kroger and Natural Grocers. So King Soopers here in Colorado, and we call Natural Grocers Vitamin Cottage. But if those are in your area, that's what this is from. So we'll start over here in the corner. So I've got some organic baby spinach, an organic spring mix, and baby arugula, and romaine hearts. So the spinach I like to lightly wilt with butter and lemon juice, my total favorite. The spring mix we just use to make salads. Sometimes I even just put a handful of spring mix under whatever I'm eating for breakfast that day to get a little extra greens in. And then the arugula, I love to toss that with olive oil, balsamic vinegar, salt, and pepper. And that's like one of my favorite salads. And I just, oh, I love it. And then the romaine hearts, I do all sorts of stuff with. We use it for on top of tacos and burritos. I use them for like little lettuce boats if I'm making like chicken salad or something, or I cut it up for salads, or you can grill it. Super, super versatile. And then back over here, I have some basil. I don't often buy fresh basil because I never seem to use it up before it goes bad. But this was on sale, and all of that basil was like crazy cheap. I think it was $2 for that whole container. And I have some chicken marinating in the fridge that I'm going to cook up tomorrow. And I'm going to make just a really easy, like, kind of like pesto, but probably without the nuts and the cheese. So it's going to be more like some garlic and basil and olive oil kind of sauce to go over the chicken after it's cooked. So I'm excited about that because I so rarely get to eat fresh basil. Then I have some organic mushrooms. These are just your regular old white mushrooms. But then I got these two new types. So white beech, and then I'm assuming this is a brown beech. I don't really know what to do with those. So my friend Amanda over at Curious Coconut, she's like the mushroom guru. So I'm going to ask her for help. But if you have suggestions for how I should cook these, let me know. I would love to know how you guys cook them if you eat them. My grocery stores don't usually have fancy mushrooms, so they had these today and I wanted to do something different. So yeah, they're kind of fancy. They're probably not fancy to other people, but they're fancy to me. And then we have some onions. These are the sweet Vidalia onions. They're local to Colorado. The growing season in Colorado is so short, really. Like, the farmers markets are all done for the season, so it's back to Kroger and Natural Grocers, but we still do have some local. I'm totally going to have to splice this together because for some reason my camera just pooped out on me. So anyways, yeah, local onions. These are the sweet Vidalias. I love those. Some organic baby potatoes. Those are going to go on the sheet pan with the chicken breasts that I'm going to cook tomorrow and roast those up. These are chayote squash. I'm probably saying that wrong. I have never eaten these before in my life. So again, if you know how to prepare these, let me know, because I kind of don't know what to do with them. I'm going to have to go to Google, but I wanted to try something different. I've got a couple of cucumbers for salads and snacks. I've got some bok choy that I'm going to chop up. I have some collard greens. I'm going to use the leaves for wraps next week, but I'm going to take the stems out and I'm going to saute those with my red cabbage. Got some avocados that are not even remotely ripe. They'll probably be ripe sometime next week. I have some parsnips that are going to go on that sheet pan with the chicken tomorrow. I'm trying to hurry so that my camera doesn't cut me off again. That was totally weird. Some uncured turkey pepperoni, just for a little something different. Beef pastrami for something different. Some of these little carrots. I really wanted the regular carrots that were multicolored, but this is all they had, so had to go with that. If you follow me on Instagram and watch my stories, you know that I'm completely addicted to this Bubby's spicy sauerkraut. Oh, this stuff is so good. If you like sauerkraut, you should totally get some of that. Then I have some of this Koyo coconut yogurt, with the plain kind with no sweetener. It is super, super good. To me, this almost tastes like sour cream. So if you're dairy-free, you can probably get away with using this how you would use sour cream. I put it in salad, like salad dressings and stuff where you would put sour cream, and it's really, really good. This is just mayo, so this is, I'm sure some of you people are going to complain about this. It is non-GMO. It does have some soy and canola in it, but I am reacting to eggs again. So I am doing eggless for a while to see if they really are causing me problems. So that's what I use in a pinch whenever I can't do regular mayo. Almond flour tortillas from Siete Foods. These things are amazing. I used to make my own tortillas all the time, and who has time for that? I have some of this, I got some of this gluten-free all-purpose baking flour, so I'm not going to really use this for baking because I don't do a ton of baking anyways, but I'm going to use this like you would use wheat flour, like for a really light breading on fish or something like that. So just something to kind of keep on hand for those instances. Unsweetened vanilla, almond breeze, the almond coconut blend, because that's what I like. And yeah, I know you can make it yourself, but I don't always have time. And so sometimes I just buy the pre-made, and there's nothing wrong with that. And then this is probably one of the only, like, quote-unquote fake foods that I buy, but the Daiya cheese slices, because this girl can't do dairy, and sometimes you just really want some cheese. I think that was everything. Oh, and then some pastured eggs. Those are for hubbies for breakfast. Yeah, so I think that's everything. There's kind of like a wide shot of it. So yeah, let me know how you guys would cook these squash thingy bobs and how you guys would cook these mushrooms. And if you have questions, let me know in the comments below. So I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.